Hi everyone, welcome or welcome back. Thank you so much for joining me. Today we're going to do a video basically that's come out of the request box, which is how do you apply watermarks to photographs in Photoshop. So this video is requested by Claire and Becky. Thank you guys, you both put the same request in the request box. We're going to look at three different ways to apply watermarks to images. I've got this image up on the screen at the moment of Alf, and I'm going to be using one of my own watermarks, which is a signature. To be able to do this, you need to make sure that your watermark that you're wanting to apply is a PNG document with a transparent background. If that's foreign, just take a sec to make sure that you can go and check. So you want that when you look at your watermark file, that it's a .png file, and that when you open it up into Photoshop, the background of it has got these like cross hatches in the background. I'm hoping you can see those. So if it doesn't have those, go back to whoever designed your logo and ask them for a transparent background PNG file. When you have your PNG file, you'll basically have something that looks like this. We're going to go through three different ways to apply. You may already know one or two of them, but I'm going to basically run through my normal ones. So the most easiest and straightforward and simple way to go about adding a watermark to an image is definitely to just open it up in your folder system and drag and drop it into Photoshop. That will put it in over the image as a smart object, which will be over there, and you can resize that to suit and just put it wherever you want to put it. Now, handy little tip, you can see that this is a black logo on a dark background I've put down here in the corner. If I press enter and lock in that transformation there, you can barely see it. What I can do though is recolor everything in that logo to a different color. I do that by double clicking on the layer in the layer stack, and then in the layer style that's popped up, switch it to color overlay, and then in color overlay, change the color to white. You can then change the opacity to 100 and click OK. That will give you a white logo now because you've colored it. With that done, you can then move your watermark wherever you wanted on the screen and change the opacity of the layer to suit the image. That is method one, reasonably straightforward there. Let's delete that off and go into method number two. Method number two is my preferred way of, you know, applying a watermark to an image. I use my libraries. So if you have an Adobe subscription on the CC, you should have access to CC libraries. If you don't have libraries in your side tab, well, you can go and make your Photoshop look like mine, or you can go window, libraries. Now we'll open up this new little window. Now I've got a lot of libraries because I've got a lot of different clients, but you can create a new library and name it. So we can name this to, I don't know, Jess, why not? And you'll end up with this gap here. Now, to have your watermark slash logo go into this section, all you need to do is open it, like we just did earlier, into Photoshop with a transparent background. And when you've got that, you just drag and drop this layer into the library. And that will now have popped that here. So then you can go back to your image, and no matter what you're doing, you can always go libraries and then click, drag and drop your watermark and move it around the image as needed. So that is another option. In terms of this image, we would probably use the white version. So open with Photoshop of the white version, click, drag, drop into libraries, and then go back to our image, click, drag, drop, and pop our watermark in. I don't really know how to put it here. Let's go for here, why not? And then blend mode, you can now change your blend mode to be anything you want it to be, to blend nicely with what's underneath it. Okay, so that is method two. That's how I personally use the libraries to apply watermarks to images. It's just a really straightforward way, and I've got these on all of my devices. Perfect. The third way to go about doing this is slightly more complicated, but it can be more creative, so we'll go and look at it anyway. So for this, you need to have open your watermark in Photoshop like this, and it doesn't matter if it's a white or a dark version, it doesn't matter. What you need to then do is make sure that the pixels are trimmed around the edge. So let's say, for example, that your PNG file has space around it like this, okay? So let's just say you've opened up your PNG file and it has space around the edges. We don't want that space. So the first thing you need to do if you've got the space is go Image, Trim. And when you go on Trim, you need to make sure that you're based on transparent pixels and have all of these options selected. When you click OK, Photoshop will take away anything that has not got any data in it. Perfect. So at this stage, we can now go and create a brush from our watermark. So we can go into Edit and then Define Brush Preset. And within Define Brush Preset, you would name your brush. So watermark, for example, and click OK. Now, if we go back to our image and then go into our brush gallery, one of them will be called whatever you've just called it. So in my case, watermark. And now, if you hover over your image, you should have a watermark. So you can change the colour of this to whatever you want it to be. So we could change it to his like eye colour, for example. Making sure that the opacity is on 100, we can then create a new layer. I personally like to have it on a new layer, but you can just paint it straight onto your image and then just click once to apply your watermark. Just press V to get back to the move tool, because then you can move that around the image and change the blend modes just like normal. And that's that, guys. That's three ways to apply a watermark to an image in Photoshop, and I hope one of them is helpful for you. If it is, please do press the subscribe button and hit the bell icon. I'd really appreciate that. I'll see you all again really, really soon.